This is Dave Chen from SlashFilm.com, and this is my review of The Hunger Games: Catching Fire. I was not a fan of the first Hunger Games when it was released in 2012. I found the world building to be lacking, the action lackluster and neutered, and the relationship between the two leads, played by Jennifer Lawrence and Josh Hutcherson, to be totally unbelievable. Just a year later, The Hunger Games: Catching Fire arrives with a bigger name director, a bigger cast, and presumably a bigger budget. So can it top its predecessor? I can confidently say this, Catching Fire is certainly better than The Hunger Games. Who would have thought that the director of I Am Legend would be better at directing a post-apocalyptic thriller than the director of Seabiscuit? Apparently, the people at Lionsgate did, and you know what? They were right. Catching Fire is an improvement on almost every single level. The cast is more impressive, and the side characters really get more time to shine this time around, especially actors such as Jeffrey Wright, Sam Claflin, and Jenna Malone. Most importantly, the world finally feels fully realized. The CG is better. The Hunger Games themselves feel more visceral and intense. The action is more thrilling. Even the fire on Katniss's outfit no longer looks absolutely ridiculous. But as a non-book fan, my primary interest in this movie is whether or not it could stand alone as a film. On this measure, I can't really say that it does. As with most books that have been adapted into films, Catching Fire feels like it elides too much character development, content to just state character motivations as fact. Tons of character moments feel totally unearned, most often in the relationship between the two leads. And I hate to say it, but I do think the weakest link here is Josh Hutcherson as Peeta Mellark. I've enjoyed Hutcherson in past films like Zathura and The Kids Are Alright, but acting against the likes of Stanley Tucci, Woody Harrelson, and Academy Award winner Jennifer Lawrence, he feels like he's in a completely different movie from everyone else. As a result, this time around, I still didn't buy the relationship between Peeta and Katniss, and that is absolutely critical later on in the film. Aside from that, this film feels content to retread many of the same beats from the first film. In Catching Fire, Katniss again finds herself trying to make her relationship with Liam Hemsworth work. She again finds herself involved in a new version of The Hunger Games, only this one deadlier and more sinister than the last. And she again encounters implausible environmental hazards and alliances that may not be what they seem. I kept waiting for it all to pay off in some way at the end, and without spoiling anything, I can tell you that I found the ending to be completely unsatisfying. I guess that was part of the point, and that it was supposed to fuel interest in the next film, but after two films and almost 5 hours of my life, I'm pretty much done waiting for the next film to really impress me and live up to the full potential of this franchise. Ultimately, I found Catching Fire to be a frustrating and unsatisfying experience. Book fans may be thrilled, but in my opinion, if you weren't a fan of the first film, this one is not going to make you a convert. This is Dave Chen from SlashFilm.com. To find more of my reviews and content, subscribe to this YouTube page, go to SlashFilm.com, follow me on Twitter @DaveChensky, or find my website at DaveChen.net.